Good morning. Let us start the embedded system DET 31002. Course outcome: students will be able to select the relevant microcontroller for various industrial applications. Students will be able to use embedded C programming language to maintain the embedded system. Students will be able to interpret the communication standards of embedded system. Students will be able to develop basic application of embedded system. Students will be able to interpret features of real-time operating system. So RTOS, real-time operating system. So we have seen in this particular unit how the programming is there, what are the SFRs are there, special function registers, their addresses are there, P0, P1, P2, P3. All these registers are 8-bit registers, their addresses are 80, 90, E0, B0. 8090, 80, B0. So these addresses are nothing but the memory locations which are reserved for the in the RAM for these SFRs. Okay. So you can initialize this by SFR P0 equal to 0x80, or it is written into the header file. That header file you can include. This we have seen yesterday. Error file you can include. So you can write on the port by equating value to the port, or you can read the port by equating variable by the port. Equate variable by port, it is reading. Equate the port by variable, it is writing on the port. So these two things we have seen. But before reading, we have to prepare the ports for reading by outputting the 1111 data, FF data. Isn't it? That, that is called setting the ports for read mode. To set the port for read mode. Isn't it? That is sending FF data on the port. This is 8051. Isn't it? In the C language, you can send it. So we have seen the structure for the single bit variable, and in that we can define any port for particular name, or assign the value of the port to the particular name. So LED_port is the variable name. To that P3 is assigned. So P3 is used as a whenever the LED_port name is written. Okay. Then in P3 we can access either 0 or 1 or 2 by using that cap value. Okay, cap symbol. So this symbol, cap symbol, can be used for particular bit access 3.0. So LED_port cap 0. This is in 3.0. Okay. So the minimum software environment needed to create an embedded system that we have seen. While is there. In that the infinite loop while 1 is there. In that infinite loop, which is called super loop or forever loop, we have the program, and that program will run for infinite time unless and until we stop by cutting the power supply. Okay. So this is while one is super. Then we have one program. We have seen the reading and writing the byte. We have read the byte from one port and we have written the same byte on the other port. And these are the displays. Usually we can check this on the port. Then creating the delays with the single for loop, with the embedded or cascaded for loop, we have seen. For longer and longer delays, we can cascade multiple for loops. So we include the RGG 51.h header file to have the register related information, that is port related information, P1, P2, P3. We can include this by this statement: hash include space less than greater than in between the header file name. So again, the void main structure is there, curly braces of the main is there, opening and closing curly braces, and whatever the program is there is written in the curly braces. Unsigned character is there, Z, then for Z equal to Z less than equal to 255, Z plus plus. This is P1Z. In this way, we can have the inclusion of header file. In this way, we can have the inclusion of header file. We include the header file. And why header file is included? Because every time we declare everything, then program becomes lengthier. So in header file, many things are declared, many things are defined, so many things are already available routines. So those functions, routines, declarations, constants, we can use in our program. Suppose port number, port addresses, we can use into our program, readily available in the header file. So that header file we can include in the program. So in header file, ready-made available values are there. So those values we can use into the program directly. So we include the reg51.h in the program. We use the P1 directly. Here we can use P1 directly. So port 1 we can use directly. P1 is equal to Z. We are not any defined any P1 except. So unsigned the char Z is defined. Z is a variable. Then for z equal to 0, z is made 0, first initialized, then z is checked less than or equal to 255, and z is incremented. So in first loop of the for, z is 0, so p1 is input outputted, p1 is outputted z, so z is 0 in first loop, so 0, 0 is outputted, then 1, 0, 1 is outputted, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 5, 0, f, then 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125, 126, 127, 128, 129, 130, 131, 132, 133, FF 255. So after FF for loop ends. Okay. So 0 to FF is same continuously. So here what we have learned, yesterday we have seen this. Careful attention on size of the data, unsigned character, that is 8 bit, use unsigned character instead of integer. Standard 8051 has 4 such 8 bit ports, P0, P1, P2, P3. 4 bit ports are there, all are 8 bit. And these are bidirectional, they may be used in both the directions, input as well as output. Now one more program. Today we will start with this program. Now suppose 8051C program is there to send hex values for ASCII characters 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C and D to port P1. ASCII character 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C, D to port P1. So these are the ASCII characters. ASCII characters are represented by 8 bit. So those can be saved in some array, and that array can be one by one element of the array can be sent or assigned to P1. So this is the logic. What is logic? ASCII character is having the 8 bits each character, then all the characters are stored in some array, and array is accessed element by element first element of array is assigned to p1, then second element of array is assigned to p1, then third element of the array is assigned to p1, and so on up to the last element of the array assigned to p1. So what we have to do? We have to send hex values for ASCII character of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C, D. How many ASCII characters are there? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C, D. 10 ASCII characters are there. 0 to 5, these are 6. A, B, C, D, these are 4. Total 10 characters are there. The port P1. Now you start again the program with include hash include less than reg51.h greater than hash include space less than reg51.h greater than include reg51. Okay. This is start of the program. We include the reg51 header file. Okay. Then there will be void main in the parenthesis void. So main is returning void. No return. So void data type main void. Then this is the parenthesis, sorry, curly brace opening, curly brace closing, curly brace opening, curly brace closing. This is for main. For this main, this is two curly braces. In between these two, opening and closing curly braces, there is a program. In the program, we define unsigned char. This is the data type, unsigned char. So each element is assigned 8-bit. Unsigned char. Unsigned char is data type and array name is myNUM. 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 Any name you can give. This is the array. Why it is array? Because in front of myNUM, immediately the square bracket opening and square bracket closing is there, isn't it? This is square bracket opening and square bracket closing is there. So this is unsigned char and myNUM. This myNUM is the variable name. And immediately after that, no space is there. Square bracket opening and square bracket closing is there. So this indicates it is array. Any variable name is continued with square bracket opening and square bracket closing. It indicates that variable name is not having single value. It is array. It is having many elements in that. So myNUM is array, myNUM is array because it is continued with square bracket opening, square bracket closing. MyNUM is array. And that array is assigned equal to, this is double quote opening, double quote closing. Double quote opening, double quote closing. In between double quotes, whatever values are written, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C, D, all these are stored into array. Light again.
So light is regained. It is array. My name is array of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C, D. The elements are stored in that, and myNUM is declared as unsigned char type, and its name is MyNUM, and immediately after that
immediately after that square bracket. Opening and closing is there, that means it indicates that it is a array, and to this array the values are immediately assigned there. You can store the values. So values are assigned and those are in the double quote 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C. These values are assigned in the array. Okay. So this is assignment and declaration. Declaration as well as assignment of the values. So unsigned char num is a value of unsigned char num. Char is the data type and my num is the value of the variable, name of the variable, and in that name these values are stored. 10 elements are stored. So if you want to access that my num elements, if you directly take my num as a value, it will give all 10 values. So in my num there are 10 elements. In my num, 0 is there, 1 is there, 2 is there, 3 is there, 4 is there, 5 is there, A is there, B is there, C is there, D is there. So 10 values are there in my num. Out of those 10 values, where 0 is kept, 0 is kept as a first element. Where 1 is kept, 1 is kept as a second element. Where 2 is kept, 2 is kept as a third element. Where 3 is kept, 3 is kept as a fourth element. Where 4 is kept, 4 is kept as a fifth element. Where 5 is kept, 5 is kept as a sixth element. Where A is kept, A is kept as a seventh element. Where B is kept, B is kept as a eighth element. Where C is kept, C is kept as a ninth element. And where D is kept in that array, D is kept as a last tenth element in the array. That means my num is having these 10 locations. So first location 0, second 1, third 2, fourth 3, fifth 4, sixth 5, seventh A, eighth B, ninth C, tenth D. Now if the all values are to be assigned or required, then only my num will be called, my num will be returned. If a particular value is required, okay, particular value, suppose only 0 is required or 0 is assessed, then what we have to take? We have to take my num, that variable name, mun, and in the square bracket its indices or index, its index. So my num 1 is taken. So my num 1 indicates the first element. My num 2 indicates the second element. My num 3 indicates the third element. My num 4 indicates the fourth element. My num 5 indicates the fifth element. Okay. My num 6 indicates the sixth element. My num 7 in the bracket. So in square bracket, if number is there, that is called index of the array. If index is there, so in this case my num bracket z is there, so this z value indicates the index of the array. It is the index of array. Okay, it is index of array. So the unsigned char z is defined. Unsigned char z, that z is having the value. That can be initialized with the for loop, because z may have value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because index is 1 to 10, isn't it? Index is rather 0 to 9. Index is 0 to 9 or 1 to 10. Index is 1 to 10. 0 is kept at first location, 1 is kept at second location, 2 is kept at third location, and so on. So either you can write the 10 statements, p1 equal to my num 1, p1 equal to my num 2, p1 equal to my num 3. You can write 10 statements. It will do. P1 will be assigned first element, my num. p1 equal to minus 2, it will assign second element to the p1. p1 equal to minus 3, it will assign third element to the p1. So such 10 statements you can write, or you can write only one for loop, you can write only single for loop, and in that for loop initialize this z equal to 0, z less than or equal to 10, increment z. So 0 is incremented 1, and then that for loop will have execution of immediate next statement, because for loop is not having any curly braces. So if no curly braces are there for for loop will execute only one statement below that. Okay, so execute this p1 and then goes again for the z equal to 2, z equal to 3, z equal to 4 in this way. So in first case p1 equal to minus 1 index, in second case p1 equal to minus 2, in third case p1 equal to minus 3 up to 10. So each time this p1 is assigned value of minus 1, 2, 3, 4 according to index. Okay, according to index minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So p1. So p1 is minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. So in this way, the array can be stored with value, or array can be accessed. So its values can be taken and assigned to any other variable. Okay. So p1 is a port. To that port, the array value can be assigned. 0 can be assigned, 1 can be assigned, 2 can be assigned, 3 can be assigned, 4 can be assigned, 5 can be assigned, and so on. E can be assigned, B can be assigned. So what is the statement? Is an 8051 program to send hex values for ASCII character 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C, D to port P1. So we have to send to the port P1 these values. So to the port P1, we have to send these values. To this port P1, we have to send these values. Okay. Port P1, we have to send these values. Okay. So first the first value is sent, then second value is sent, then third value is sent, then fourth value is sent, and this is done in the for loop. And index is varied by the for loop. Z equal to 0, z less than or equal to 10, z incremented by 1. So my num z is there. So whatever value of z is there, that will be index of my num. P1 is equal to my num 1, P1 equal to my num 2, P1 equal to my num 3, P1 equal to my num 4, and so on up to 10. And after 10, it comes out of the for loop. And again, if it is ending the program, if it is using the while one, then it will go into infinite super loop. Here super loop is not there, it will indicate execute only once. Okay, so it will stop here. After for loop, it will come out of the for loop and it will stop here. So this is the program. That program is having the array, use of array. That array is storing different elements, 10 elements, and those 10 elements, one by one element is accessed, and those are assigned to port P1. Port P1 will have one by one elements assigned to it. Okay, so this is about this program. The next program, I think, hope you have understood the details of the array, how the array are there. In array, multiple elements are stored, same type of the multiple elements. If they are unsigned char, all the unsigned char. If they are integer, all are integer. The array is storing same type of the multiple elements. And these multiple elements can be accessed by array's name and square bracket its index. If index is 1, first element, index is 2, second element, and so on. So this thing we have understood. The next is an 8051C program to toggle all P1 bits continuously. Toggle आपण पाहिलेलं आहे ना सकाळी in the open source software and hardware. Toggle means what? Suppose the value is 1, change it to 0, it is called toggle. If value is 0, change it to 1, it is called toggle. 1 is changed to 0, 0 is changed to 1, it is called toggling. Toggling means whatever existing value is there, that value is changed to other value. It is called toggling. Okay. Toggle means change one value to other value. In binary, two values are there, 1 and 0. So toggling will change one value to 0, 0 value to 1. 1 level to 0 level, 0 level to 1 level. 0 hold to 5 hold, 5 hold to 0 hold. Okay. 8051C program to toggle all P1 bits continuously. Continuously toggling is required. Continuously means all P1 bits, suppose are having 1111, you can convert it to 0000, again 1111, again 0000. This is one thing, one way. Second, 55A is there. How 55 is written? How 55 is written? 55 is nothing but 0101 is 5. Again 01. Sorry, I am writing 5. 0101. This is 5. So this is 5 and this is 5. 55 is written 0101. And what about AA? How AA is written? A is written 1010. AA is written 1010. 1010. Okay. 1010. So 55 is written 0101. A is written 1010. So this data is used. So once the 55 is sent out, so for this pin it is 0, for next pin it is 1, for this pin it is 0, this pin it is 1, and so on. So in when A is sent, 0 pin which is having 0 will become 1, pin which is having 1 become 0, pin which is having 0 become 1, pin which is having 1 become 0. 0, 1, 1, 0. 0, 1, 1, 0. Again 1 is there, A is sent, then again 55 is sent. So 1 becomes 0, 0 becomes 1. 1 becomes 0, 0 becomes 1. A becomes 55, 55 becomes A, A becomes 55. But this loop should be continuous. It should be super loop or continuous loop or infinite loop. This loop should be continuous, and that is done in this program. So what is the program? Is the 8051C program to toggle all P1 bits continuously. To toggle all the P1 bits continuously. And 8051C program to toggle all P1 bits continuously. All P1 bits continuously. Toggle P1 forever. This is the format. Now what we have done? Include reg51.h, void main is there, void, the curly braces of the void main, opening of the curly brace, closing of the curly brace, void main chat. Then for loop is there, for loop initialization is not there, condition checking is not there, increment is not there, only the two semicolons are there, initialization, semicolon, condition checking, semicolon, and increment. So out of that, only two semicolons are kept. Initialization, condition checking, and increment all not present. So this for double semicolon becomes infinite loop. Because for checking it is not anything. For initialization it is not anything. And increment it is not anything. Okay? Nothing is there for condition checking. So always it is true and it is continuously iterating. So this for loop is continuously working. Okay, it will not stop unless and until the power supply of the board is made off. So while one and for double semicolon, both are super loops or infinite loops in the embedded C. So in open source software and hardware, in Arduino, we have seen loop is the infinite. So for this for statement, there is opening of the curly brace and there is a closing of the curly brace. So for this for statement, this opening of the curly brace and closing of the curly brace is executed infinite times, and within that whatever is written instructions, they are executed. So P1 equal to 0x55 and P1 equal to 0xAA, these are executed for infinite time. Okay, these are executed for infinite time. So P1 is 55, then P1 is A, then again P1 is 55, then again P1 is A, then again P1 is 55, then again P1 is A. So this is executed infinite times. And in this way, the program is achieved. In this way, the program is achieved. Okay, you understood this? I think, hope you have understood this. Any queries, you can raise your queries anytime. Then the C compilers use the signed char as the default. If the keyboard unsigned is not used, the C compiler use signed char as a default. If keyboard default, if the keyboard unsigned is not used. Okay, so unsigned is not used specifically. Compiler uses signed character. Care. If it is not given, it is unsigned, then it is assumed as signed the care. If you give the keyboard directly entering the keyboard value, it will assume as signed the care. The signed the care is 8-bit data type. Again, care is 8-bit data type, unsigned 8-bit and signed also 8-bit. So signed care is 8-bit data type. Okay. Signed care is 8-bit data type. And use the MSB D7 MSB to represent 0 or 1 or plus or minus. Okay. To represent plus or minus. And thus the it gives the values from minus 128 to plus 127. Okay. The unsigned carry is usually used unless the data needs to be represented as signed numbers. Normally unsigned char is used. Always unsigned char is used. Why? Because it is giving the range 0 to 255. And most of the applications require 0 to 255. Unless and until minus 128 to plus 127 are required, then and then only signed numbers are used. Signed char. Otherwise unsigned char is always used. So C compiler is assuming by default, if you are not given anything, it will assume signed char. But specifically unsigned char is given, then it can take it as a unsigned char. So this we have to remember. Generally we have to use unsigned char. So generally we have to write unsigned char in the data type declaration. So unsigned char is mostly used, so we have to write unsigned char in the declaration. So next program is to send values of minus 4 to plus 4 to port P1. Values of minus 4 to plus 4 to port P1. Okay. Values of minus 4 to plus 4 to port P1. So double backslash signed numbers are there. Double backslash signed numbers. And that inclusion of reg51.h is also there. Then void main, void is starting of the program, curly braces opening, curly braces closing. Then char myname, char myname. Myname is again same variable name used for the three students. Okay. Minum is curly brace. Minum is the variable name used for the array, because the opening and closing of the square bracket is there after that name. And equals to, you can give within the double quote or you can give curly braces also. The elements of the array can be given in the curly braces. Plus 1, comma, minus 1, comma, plus 2, comma, minus 2, comma, plus 3, comma, minus 3, comma, plus 4, comma, minus 4, comma. So total 8 different digits or 8 different values are there in the array. So it is 8 element array. 8 element array. In the previous program it was 10 element array. It is 8 element array. Total 8 elements are there. So unsigned char z is defined. Unsigned char z. For loop is started. For z equal to 0, z less than or equal to 8, z is incremented by 1, z plus plus. Then p1 is assigned minum bracket z. So z is 1, z is 2, z is 3, z is 4, z is 5, z is 6, z is 7, z is 8. So 8 times the for loop executes, and each time p1 is assigned first value, second value, third value, fourth value, fifth value, sixth value, seventh value, eighth value. So p1 is assigned minum 0, 1 to 8 elements, first element to eighth element. So this is again the same program logic. Instead of double quote, here curly brace and comma is used for assigning the values. And instead of unsigned char, only char is used. So only char assumes it as a signed char. So its value is minus 128 to plus 127. So minus 1 and plus 1, minus 2 and plus 2, minus 3 and plus 3, minus 4 and plus 4 values are used in this. So we are sending values of minus 4 to plus 4 to port 1. So this is the program. Sending the values minus 4 to plus 4 to the port 1. An 8051C program, next program, 8051C program to toggle bit D0. 8051 program to toggle bit D0 of port P1, P1.0, 50,000 times. An 8051C program to toggle bit D0 of port P1, P1.0, 50,000 times. 50,000 times. Light gele ani aleli ahe, pan ata internet yala 1 minute lagel. Due to the electricity switching problem, 1 minute was there to internet regain. I will share the document again. Okay, let us check the another program, an 8051 program to toggle bit D0 of port P1, P1.0. Bit D0 of port P1 means P1.0. Bit D0 of port P1. P1 is a port which is having 8 bits, isn't it? So out of those 8 bits, P1 point, which bit? D0. 1, 0. If D1 is there, P1.1. If D2 is there, P1.2. D3 is there, P1.3. D4 is there, P1.4. And so on. D5 is there, P1.5, P1.6, P1.7, 0 to 7. So P1.0, 50,000 times toggle karayche. Toggle karayche manje kaay? 1 send karayche, 0 send karayche. 1 send karayche, kiwa 0 send karayche, 1 send karayche. 0 send karayche, 1 send karayche. Ekda 0 send kela ki to 0 hoil, mag 1 send karayche, toggle hoil. Puna 0 send karayche, toggle hoil, puna 1 send karayche, toggle hoil. So 50,000 times karayche. 50,000 times. Kashala beat D0 of port P1. बीट D0 पोर्टला. सिंगल बीटला आपण ऍक्सेस करायचं असेल तर एस बीट वापरायला लागतो आपल्याला. एस बीट सिंगल बीट ऍक्सेस करायचं असेल तर एस बीट इजंट इट. आपण एस बीटचा प्रोग्राम पाहिलेला आहे मागच्या लेक्चरला. ओके सो लेट अस चेक द यूज ऑफ एस बीट अगेन. यूज ऑफ एस बीट सिंगल बीट. सो द इन्क्लूजन इज देअर हॅश इन्क्लूड REG51.h hash include REG51.h. okay, include REG51.h. yes bit single bit, it is capital MYBIT my bit equals to yes bit my bit equals to P1 कॅप 0. ओके एस बीट इज अ डेटा टाईप मीन्स सिंगल बीट. एस बीट इज अ डेटा टाईप मीन्स सिंगल बीट. सिंगल बीट इट इज. एस बीट इज अ सिंगल बीट. माय बीट कॅपिटल माय बीट MYBIT इट इज अ व्हेरिएबल नेम. इफ यू आर रायटिंग इट एज अ कॅपिटल माय बीट ऑलवेज यू हॅव टू राईट इन द प्रोग्राम कॅपिटल माय बीट. व्हॉट एव्हर यू डिफाईन द नेम सेम नेम यू हॅव टू यूज. My bit 1, my num, whatever name you give, the same name you have to use for the variable in the program. So here my bit is name given by us, by the programmer. We can change my bit to any name. So this is the variable name. S bit is the data type. So data type is single bit. So my bit will store single bit. So my bit is equal to P1 cap 0. So my bit is P1.0. P1 cap 0 means P1.0. So in program we cannot write P1.0. We have to write keep P cap 0 because compiler identifies cap. P1 it identifies port 1 and cap number it identifies that particular bit in that port. 0 means 0th bit, 1 means first bit, 2 means second bit and so on. So S bit my bit equals to P1 cap 0. S bit is data type, my bit is a variable name and it is P1 cap 0, that is P1.0. So again this is the variable declaration. So void is there, main void, and curly brace open and curly brace close is there for the main void. In there the code is written, program code of the main is written, that is unsigned int z is declared, then for loop is there, z is equal to 0, z is less than or equal to 50,000, increment z, because we have to do it 50,000 times, isn't it? We have to toggle it for 50,000 times, which is given in the problem statement. Okay. So we are taking 50,000 as a counter. Isn't it? It is a counter. And to this for loop there is a curly brace opening and curly brace closing. To this for loop there is a curly brace opening and curly brace closing because more than one instruction is used. So two instructions are there. So curly brace opening, curly brace closing is there. My bit equal to 0, my bit equal to 1. My bit equal to 0 and my bit equal to 1. So these are the two bits. My bit equal to 0, my bit equal to 1. These are the, two instructions, not two bits. Two instructions, those are executed under for loop. My bit equal to 0, semicolon, and my bit equal to 1, semicolon. These are the two instructions executed under for loop. Okay. For the for loop, my bit equal to 0 and my bit equal to 1. These are the two instructions executed. Okay. For loop, two instructions are executed. My bit equal to 0, my bit equal to 1. And for loop continues till 50,000 times. for loop continues till 50,000 times, z equal to 0, z less than or equal to 50,000, z increment. For loop is executing for 50,000 times from 0 to, it starts from, it increments 1 to 50,000. It is 50,000 times it is increment. So the note is written, the S bit keyword allows access to the single bits of SFR registers. Special function registers are there, P0, P1, P2, P3 are SFR, special function registers, and S bit keyword gives the access or allows the access to the single bit of SFR. सिंगल बीट ऑफ एस एफ आर ला एक्सेस करू देतो, करायला आपल्याला परमिशन देतो किंवा अलाउ करतो. काय तर एस बीट हा कीवर्ड. सो दिस इज अबाउट यूज ऑफ एस बीट अँड आउटपुटिंग द डेटा ऑन अ सिंगल बीट. Outputting the data on single bit. Then let us check the next program, an 8051C program to toggle. 8051C program to toggle bits of P1 continuously forever. 8051C program to toggle bits of P1. इव्हनच्या सगळ्या बिट्स 8 कंटिन्युअसली टॉगल करायचे, म्हणजे 5 5 A असं सेट करायचं. पण सम डिले इज देअर, विथ सम डिले. अगोदरचा प्रोग्राम आपण टॉगल केला होता बिट्स, बट विदाऊट एनी डिले. हा प्रोग्राम आपण विदाऊट एनी डिले केला, 5 5 सेंड केल्या पोर्ट वनला, पी वनला, की लगेच ए ए सेंड करायचा पी वनला, की लगेच 5 5 सेंड करायचा, की लगेच ए ए सेंड करायचा, की लगेच 5 5 सेंड करायचा, की लगेच ए पी वनला. इथं डिले वापरलेला नाही, देर इज नो यूज ऑफ डिले हियर. बट नाव वी कॅन, वी हॅव टू यूज डिले. सेम प्रोग्राम इज देअर, सेम प्रोग्राम, बट वी हॅव टू यूज डिले. वॉट इज द प्रोग्राम लॉजिक or what is required in the program is 8051 program is there, 8051 program to toggle bits, to toggle the bits of P1 continuously forever. 8051C program is there to toggle the bits continuously forever, infinite loop, and continuously toggle karayche. जी बीट 1 होती त्याला 0 करायचं आहे, जी 0 होती त्याला 1 करायचं, हे कंटिन्युअस करायचं फॉर एव्हर विथ सम डिले. सम डिले इज इंट्रोड्यूस इन बिटवीन ईच टॉगलिंग. एकदा टॉगल झाला की डिले अप्लाय करायचा, पुन्हा टॉगल करायचा, डिले अप्लाय करायचा. सो ओनली वी हॅव टू ॲड डिले. ओके, सो लेट अस चेक द प्रोग्राम. टॉगल पी वन फॉर एव्हर विथ सम डिले इन द बिटवीन, दिस इज द कॉमेंट, बॅकस्लॅश on and off. One more comment is added, on and off. Okay, then include reg51.h for using the ports. We have to include the reg51.h. void main void, then curly brass opening of the main and curly brass closing of the main. So the program will be there in between curly brass opening and curly brass closing. So this is the main program. In main program there is an unsigned integer x. X is variable declaration. Declaration of x variable is there. X is the name of the variable. Which type of the variable it is? What is its data type? Data type is unsigned int. Int means integer, but it is not signed, it is unsigned. No sign is there, unsigned int. So data type is unsigned int, 16 bits are reserved. Unsigned means it is having no sign, 0 to 6 5 5 3 5 3 5. Okay, unsigned int. तो 65535 65,000 टाइम्स इज अ रेंज 65,000 इज अ रेंज दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन यूज वैल्यू 40,000 इजंट इट इट इज अनसाइंड इन देयर फोर दिस वैल्यू कैन बी 65,000 अदरवाइज माइनस 35 और 2 प्लस 35 इट विल बी वैल्यू बिटवीन दैट सो अनसाइंड इंट x इज देयर सो फॉर कोलन कोलन फॉर कोलन कोलन backslash repeat forever backslash repeat forever okay for colon colon backslash repeat forever for back colon semicolon semicolon means it is infinite loop then in that infinite loop for loop curly bracket opening is there curly bracket closing is there okay curly bracket opening and curly bracket closing so this is the instructions under for loop these are the instructions under for loop what are the instructions p1 equal to 0x55 so 55 is assigned to P1. So 55 is outputted on P1. Okay. Now value of the P1 port will be 0101, 55. Then there is a for loop. In for loop, x is unsigned integer is 0, x less than 40,000, increment x. For x equal to 0, x less than 40,000, increment x. This is the delay. This is the delay of unknown value. Delay of unknown value. Okay. For x equal to 0, x less than 40,000, increment x. This is the delay of unknown value. Okay. This is the for loop, delay. Okay. So, P1 is 0x55. Is outputted, delay is given. How much delay? Delay size is unknown. So we can calculate it by taking the frequency and the T state and the machine state, etc. So some delay is there. So this for loop executes up to 40,000 and then goes to next. That is P1 equal to AA. Now whatever the 0101 was there, it converted to 1010. So it is toggling 55 to A. Again after A, for loop is there which is having x equal to 0, x less than 40,000, increment x. This is also one more delay. After executing this delay, again it goes to first instruction under the for repeat forever loop. This is a repeat forever loop, for semicolon semicolon. So first instruction is again P1 x55, again for loop x less than 40,000 increment x, then again p1 0x a, then again for x equal to 0, x less than 40,000 increment x. After completing this for loop, again goes to p1 55 and it continues for infinite time. So whatever the previous program was there, the same program is there, is used here. Only thing is the addition of some delay routines are there after each. Port assignment. Port P1 assignment 55 is there, delay is introduced. Then port P1 assignment A is there, then again delay is introduced. So this is toggling the bits of P1 continuously forever with some delay. Toggling the bits of P1 continuously forever with some delay. This is the program for toggling but with some delay. Again the toggling is there, an 8051C program to toggle bits of P1, 8051C program to toggle bits of P1 port. We are accessing port, we are writing on the port, isn't it? So this is port interaction, this is port transfer of data transfer on the port. 8051 C program to toggle the beats of 4 P1. P1 च्या beats आहेत त्या toggle करायच्या आहेत आपल्याला 8051 program मध्ये. Continuously करायच्या आहेत with 250 millisecond delay. With 250 millisecond. 250 millisecond नी continuous करत राहायचं आहे toggling. 1 असेल तर 0, 0 असेल तर 1, 55 असेल तर A, A असेल तर 55. Again the same program. But the delay now is 250. Delay is 250 millisecond. So just check the program. Include REG51.h. Include REG51.h. Wide main, sorry, before that wide MS delay unsigned integer. So wide MS delay unsigned integer is a function. Wide main function is there, before that one more function is defined, and that is wide MS delay. MS delay is the function which is not a wide function, it is unsigned integer. It is unsigned integer. So wide MS delay in parenthesis unsigned integer. So MS delay is a function. So main function is there, void main void. Main function is void main void. So main function has curly brace opening and curly brace closing. So this is only the main function. Curly brace opening and curly brace closing. And within that there is a code of main function. So this is code of main function. Code of main function. Below that the code of other function is there. Void MS delay unsigned integer. This is another function which is defined in the before main function. And this function is having curly brace opening and curly brace closing here. And its program is there. Okay. So there are two functions. One is main function, which one is other function, that is named as MS delay. One is main function and other is MS delay function. Other is MS delay function. Okay. So please understand. One is main function, other is MS delay function. So again in main function, while one is there, while one is repeat forever. This is the comment. Double backslash is a comment. This is double backslash. So it is a comment. After double backslash up to end of the line, it will be considered as a comment. Repeat forever is a comment. So while one is repeating forever, repeating continuously, while one is repeating continuously. So this is a curly brace of while, opening curly brace of while and closing curly brace of while. Okay. So while is having this program. While is having this program. While is having this program. While one. P1 equal to 0x55. P1 equal to 0x55. This is assignment of 55 to port P1. P1 equal to 0x55. This is assignment of 55 to P1. Okay. Assignment of 55 to P1. Then there is a delay, MS delay. There is a delay, MS delay, that is 250. There is a delay, MS delay, that is 250. Okay. P1 is a 0x55. Assignment of 55 to port P1. Then there is a delay which is having the function MS delay. M capital, S capital, D capital, E L A Y. MS delay. Okay. and that is MS delay is having argument 250. MS delay is having argument 250 in the bracket. Okay, MS delay is having argument 250 in the bracket. That means 250 is argument passed in the MS delay. So what is MS delay? MS delay is a function which is written here. Void MS delay. And unsigned int I time. I time is the time internal entered or required. Okay. Because time is the name we are not using, we are using I time name. Okay. Or time underscore delay. You can use time underscore delay. Any name you can use. Then you here where you have to use, instead of I time, you have to use time underscore delay. Okay. So we are passing I time in the MS delay. We are passing 250. So here the MS delay takes 250. Then in the MS delay, unsigned integer I and j are in defined. Unsigned integer I and j. Then for loop I equal to 0, I less than I time. I time is 250 now. Here MS delay 250 is entered here, isn't it? In next MS delay also 250 is entered. So I time is 250, unsigned integer. So this I is less than I time, less than 250, increment I. Again for j is less than 1275, increment j. So 250 multiplied by 1075. Okay. 250 multiplied by 1275. It is 318750. It is totally, it is executing the loops 318750. Okay. So 1275 multiplied by 250. 1275 gives 1 millisecond. So multiplied by 250 gives 250 millisecond. Okay. So it gives the 250 millisecond delay. So how it is giving 250 millisecond? Because if you consider 12 megahertz clock frequency, divide 12 megahertz by this number, you will get 1 upon 12 megahertz by this number, you will get 250 milliseconds. Okay. 318750. 1 divided by 12 megahertz. 1 divided by 12 megahertz. Okay. So megahertz 10 raised to minus 6. So it is 0.083 microsecond. Isn't it? Multiplied by, for one T state, multiplied by 318750 times. So it is 26562 times. So 26562 T states it is taking. So how much machine cycles? So this one for loop takes some number of T states, clock cycles, and this for loop execution takes some number of clock cycles, and whatever number of clock cycles are there, those number of clock cycles multiplied by 1275, it gives those many T states multiplied by its time. It gives the 1 millisecond time. If you take 1275 number counter, it can execute for loop for 1 millisecond. So if we are again executing for 250 outer for loop, then it will give 250 millisecond total. So 1275 is for 1 millisecond. So this can be proved by calculation. We will prove in the next some slides. So MS delay 250 will provide 250 millisecond delay. Again P1 is given, 0xAA. If 0xAA will have output AA instead of 55, so toggling is there. Again MS delay 250 is called. MS delay 250 is again going here and the executing this routine. After executing this routine and completing the delay of 250 milliseconds, again it goes to the first instruction because it is while 1. It is while 1. So it goes into P1 again and it executes 0x55. P1 equal to 0x55. So again from AA it will get converted to 55. So P1 becomes, instead of AA it becomes 55. Again the delay of 250 milliseconds and then again delay of, after delay 250 milliseconds, toggling is there. Again toggling, delay of 250 milliseconds is there. And this continues. So here what we have studied, the regular inclusion of the header file is there and main wide definition is there. And one more thing is there, we can define the function here. We can define the function. And while one loop, while one is infinite loop we are knowing, then assignment of P1 and assignment of P1A and 55 toggling we are knowing. But use of this MS delay function is there, MS delay 255, 250 is argument. And declaration of the function is here and the definition of the function is here. That is the programming of the function is here. After main function, programming of the function is there. Okay. So this we have seen, defining the function and using the function and programming of the function. Defining is before main, using is the in the main program, and defining the function is below the program. Declaring the function is above the main, using the function is in the main program, and defining the function, declaring and defining or writing the program of the function is below main function. So you can go for the references, embedded C by Pont EMJ publisher, additional publisher is additional is say, Pont EMJ is the writer, embedded C by Pont EMJ, publisher is additional is say, 2002. Similarly, A05 microcontroller and embedded systems using the assembly and C, Muhammad Ali Azdi, this Gillespie and Majidi, and Roland D. McKinney, publisher is British Hall Incorporated, second edition. So these are the references you can refer, either Pont EMJ embedded C or 805 microcontroller embedded system by Majdi and Majdi, British Hall. Thank you, be at home, be healthy, be safe. We will stop here for the embedded system today.